Tangga Meru, Highland, founder of Intelligence Society of Malaysia. I'd like to share about 27 years of research-oriented experience towards developing kids, children, teenage, and also university college graduates in the area of academic, sports, tournament, and naturally healthier. Usually, we talk about primary school. We will found various types of developing or nurturing children. For example, when we teach them, some of the children will be able to adopt, learn, and give the output as what we want. For example, they're able to read, write, and do basic mathematics and arithmetic of the maths. This will lead towards to the children will able to study and do performance a good grades in other subjects beyond language and math subjects, such as ICT, geography, science, pendidikan moral, and so on. The matter now we are going to discuss will be, there will be around 70% or to our visitings and challenges we found in schools, 30% of the students in school, especially SK, SJKT schools, primary school, after the age of standard 4, 5, 6, the students not able to read, write, and doing basic arithmetic or maths. This leads towards to they are finishing at UPSR or standard 6 without able to handle language, not only their mother tongue, and also the second, third language, so-called, let's say, their mother tongue can be Tamil or even Mandarin. And the second, third language we can categorize under Bahasa Malaysia and English. When they're not able to perform well in these languages, they will end up with having less marks or almost not able to get a proper grade and certificate in UPSR. Not only a certificate matter, when they enter the secondary school, so-called Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan, the issue become bigger where they have less performance in academic. The attention of these kids and children will be towards to non-good activity. That means not good activity. For example, they become less disciplined students. They talk and involve in non-academic activities with internal school students and external peoples. This will lead towards to indirectly, we are creating and molding the highest percentage of social issue-based secondary students. The input is come from the primary school. So, when we talk about this area, the discussion and the negotiation or the objection or even the brainstorm will be especially from education ministries, state education ministries, or even district education office, including guru besar or pengetua and teachers, counselors, even YDP PIBG, who is the president of teachers, parents, associations, divisions, groups, also they will have such a words. For example, oh, we have done the best, the students not able to perform in the basic languages and maths. That's not a matter of handling in school. And usually they will comment, issue they will comment is the issue of at home or issue of the particular child. They don't do homework. There's no guidance at home to do homework, to continue perform based on what is a responsibility done in school. Now, our research confirm a child studying in a school more than 4 hours or 5 hours, up to 6 hours in primary, which is standard 1, 2, 3, before they enter standard 4. Even though they are not bringing books to the home, even though there is no guidance happen in at home, even though the these child or children do not do homework and revision at home, we have developed methodology where the school teaching and training and school classes should be sufficient to nurture so that they able to perform like other students. That means they re-catch up back the ability to talk, speak, read, write into the multiple language from their mother tongue and towards to Bahasa Malaysia and English. This research-oriented formulas and the methodology being designed into workshop and classes. These workshops are categorized or grouped towards to teaching and training teacher psychology, teaching and training parental psychology, teaching and training and mentorship them towards to long term, for example, up to 1, 2, or 3 years time from starting of the 2 days workshop. That means if we have not done a major solutions, that's the reason we have a big quantity of the students without language ability. We have the solutions where we inviting schools, Guru Besar, Pengetua, YDP, PIBG, parents, counselors to share this knowledge, where we are offering these programs, nurturing these students, even though they are already in a school up to standard 4 now, standard 5, standard 6, they're not able to read, write, and speak well languages. They can't do basic arithmetic. Yet, we have proven record, proven methodology, proven statistics, where within 90 days, they will start to have at least passing marks. They will start to able to speak, read, write. Of course, there is a therapy or requirement to teach more vocabulary-based words to cover or discover the so-called 10, 20, and 30,000 words in their life. That will be a second phases to approach them. Now, first of all, we have to support and help them, these kids where they are already in a Center 4, Center 5, Center 6. They should able to increase the cognitive skill, which they already cannot able to handle languages. We cannot go and teach them based on a skill-based knowledge. We have training where game-based, forum-based, and it's a technique-based, and it's scientifically proven to improve the ability to increase memory, ability to switch and handle new languages, ability to respond back when the time required to answer cross-language. For example, they can be Indian or Chinese, even Malay, they should able to understand cross-words, meaningful words and meaning of the required answer from mother tongue to Bahasa Malaysia to English. Now, we have done almost 25,000 participants from 15 countries. The result is massive, but a great results. And the improvement, if I want to give an example statistics, from 35, 15 marks, 10 marks for the kids of Center 4, 5, 6, we able to improve up to 75 marks. They able to read, write, speak as other normal students within 90 days. It is a kind of a magic in education industry. Yes, we have done it. It is a world's first interesting methodology training to improve cognitive skill, and byproduct is they become naturally healthier. And the next benefit is they perform very well in sports, winning gold medals, and again tournament, they can enter quiz and other challenges, local, international, as well as global arena. They also able to and already obtaining medals, first place, gold medals back to Malaysia. So again, I'm Ilangowen Tangabelu, Ilan, founder and president of Intelligence Society of Malaysia. Our website is www.intelligencesocietyofmalaysia.org, and you can contact our corporate centralized phone number with WhatsApp 6019-6199-100. 6019-6199-100. You can explore our Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter to get latest updates. You can visit our website for our master solution for the community to local Malaysia and global. You can contact this number to discuss to how to offer this program in your school. I'm sure every school in Malaysia have a different percentage, but generally when I see the statistics is every school having 30% issue children where they can't read, write and speak well in multiple languages as well as arithmetic with the basic mathematics, which really critical statistics for the school teachers, parents, as well as the education industry growth and towards the nation growth in a big, in a vast discussions. I wish you as a person watching this video and listening this master point, which we should nurture our community, which will be the whole sum of the nation will be harmony, healthier and great development in the coming year. Yes, I understand and I trust we have developed very well in the academy industry. And again, I'd like to tell you, these statistics can be improved with proven methodology. We, ISOM, Intelligence Society of Malaysia, offering service across the country, including Sabah, Sarawak, Labuan, and all the states, all the towns, all the districts, all the schools, especially primary school. Give us a call. We have a standard operating procedure. We have a documented task we done. We have a process which we can audit before and after. We work very well with teachers, parents, PIBGs, and children. Last 10 years, we have done a massive track records. And again, we are exploring current year 2018 for bigger solution for more schools to penetrate and to see and witness and enjoy the improvement with our kids in a bigger statistics. Ilangowen Tangavelu, Ilan, founder and president of ISOM. Thank you very much.